Hello, first graders. It's Miss Beyer. Welcome to Social Studies. Today in Social Studies, we are going to continue our conversation about mapping. Let's just review quickly some of the things we've already learned with Mr. Khan and Miss Azizo. A map is a picture that shows us a place. The place a map shows us can be anywhere. A map can be drawn of our rooms, our street, our school, our city, our country, or even our world. A map can show us what it looks like inside our bodies, under a city, or beneath the ocean. We can even make a map of a pretend world. I know last week we also talked about a compass rose. A compass rose shows us our cardinal directions. There's north, east, south, and west. Today in social studies, we are going to talk about symbols on maps. A symbol is something that stands for something else. For example, a plus sign stands for addition, and a minus sign stands for subtraction. A heart is a symbol for love, and a flag is the symbol for our country. There are many other symbols we use too. So sometimes when we are looking at maps, we see something called a map key. And inside the map key is where we can find all the different symbols that we will find on our maps. So here is an example of a map key. When I see a symbol that looks like these triangles here, that means it's representing mountains. Or if I see this bullet point, it would be a city. Or this X would be an airport. Very cool. So grab your worksheet that looks like this, and we are going to do this one together. So the first thing I do is always the same. I pick up my pencil and I write my name. So please make sure your name is at the top here. I'm going to write my name in my nice, neatest handwriting. All right, symbols on a map. Map symbols help us read a map. A symbol on a map stands for something real. It is easy to see where something is on a map. You can look for the symbol. So here I see our map key. It has our map symbols. There's an airport, a house, road, mountains, lake, railroad, bridge, and park. And here is our map. Read the symbols and color the maps. All right, color the houses brown. So I need to get my brown crayon. And now I need to look at my symbols here and see which one is the house. Oh, it's right here. This is the symbol that represents house. So everywhere I see that, I'm going to color it brown. I see that there are three houses up here, and then there are two houses down here. Next, it says color the mountains red. So I will change my color to red. And now I need to look for the mountain symbol. Ooh, the mountain symbol is right here. It is a triangle. So when I see that symbol, I have to color it red. Please make sure you're coloring neatly. Mine is doing my neatest, but it could probably be a little neater. All right, then it says draw an orange circle around the airport. Which symbol is the airport? Yes, I see it. It is this quick sketch of an airplane. So I will draw an orange circle around it. Mark a purple X on the bridge. So let's all change our markers or crayons to purple. Mark an X on the bridge. I will give you a few seconds to do this on your own and then we could check it. Mark a purple X on the bridge. I looked at the symbols. I see that this symbol here represents the bridge, so I put a purple X on it. Color the roads green. ooh, these are the roads here. So all of this needs to be colored green. Here are my roads. Draw a blue box around the lake. Where is the lake? Ooh, let's see, I see it's this symbol. So I need to find this symbol on the map. Ooh, here is the lake. So we'll draw a blue box around it. Draw black railroad tracks through the mountains. Ooh, interesting. So let's get our blacks out. Here I see that this is the symbol for the railroad. So I need to now draw this symbol where I see the mountains. Ooh, looking back at my key, I see that the mountains are in triangles. So right here I found my mountains. So now I will draw that symbol for the railroad. Then the last one. Draw a yellow circle around the park. Let's look again at our map symbols. I see the park is a tree. So I will draw a yellow circle around the park. Fantastic job, first graders. Now let's look at this sheet. Here it says mapping blank worlds. On this blank, I want you to write your name. So mine now says mapping Miss Byers world. Draw a map of your bedroom and a key to go with it. So I know we've already drawn a map of our bedroom with Mr. Khan. So if you still have that, you can look at that as a reference. If you don't, that's okay, because we are going to make new maps of our bedroom, because this time we need to include a map key. We are going to use some symbols. So thinking about some of the things I have in my bedroom, I have a lamp, so I might do a little lamp symbol, and then I have to also make sure I include what that symbol represents. So somebody reading my map understands what all the symbols are. I also have a bed. I did notice that when we were looking at the symbols were simple drawings. They weren't this grand drawing. So when I'm thinking about my key, I want to make sure that I'm thinking of something simple. Then, what else is in my bedroom? I'm going to keep thinking. And I want to make sure that I have at least 5 or more things in my key. Once I have them in my key, I need to go and start to map them. I know I have a bed over here. I have a few lamps in my room. And then I want to keep going and using up all my symbols. I do have to make sure, though, if I'm going to draw more than one lamp, they all need to be the same so that somebody looking at my map can easily read it. Okay. First graders, you may get started now on mapping your world. I cannot wait to see how everybody's map turns out. Have fun.